Welcome back to The Blend. When it comes to dieting, it's a fact that many people around the world are deficient in omega-3s. That puts us at risk for all kinds of health issues such as heart disease and Alzheimer's, just to name a few. And did you know that there's actually a simple test that you can take that can help?
Well, as a matter of fact, I do.
Yes.
Because I took it, and so did you, and so did other people here in the building. Your internationally recognized omega-3 expert, Dr. Bill Harris, is here with The Morning Blend. We have the results from our team, and we're going to talk about why omega-3s are just so important. Great having you, my friend.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Welcome in.
I've heard of omega-3s before. You hear it sometimes in like the supplement commercials or whatever, and I don't think people understand what omega-3s are.
Right.
Let's talk about the omega-3 index. What exactly is this?
Well, to your first point, what are omega-3s? Yeah. Mm-hmm. They are fatty acids, fats, oils that we can get primarily from seafood is the primary source.
Gotcha.
And we need them to have our cells and our bodies working the very best. Mm-hmm. The omega-3 index is a blood test that measures the amount of omega-3 in our blood.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And what's the test you guys
this
do?
This is taking out the dipstick and checking the levels.
It's checking your oil.
Yeah,
right, exactly.
Yeah.
I like that.
And we're gonna talk about how we can take that test in just a moment, but what kind of levels are you looking for? There's actually an index that shows you where you fall. What's a healthy level
right.
of omega-3s?
Yeah, we work long and hard to try and figure out what a healthy omega-3 index is. And our data says about 8%. Most Americans are down in the under 4.5%.
Oh boy.
Okay.
But 8% is really the target.
And we're looking at, that was just the graph right there. I know I got my levels, not 8%.
No.
Fun fact.
Mine either.
Let's take a look at our staff did with this. Wow, I have the lowest. Well, this is just like high school. This is reminding me a lot, Doctor. Is this relatively par for the course from what you see?
Exactly par for the course.
Wow.
Unless you're eating fish regularly, and particularly oily fish like salmon, mackerel, herring, tuna, that kind of stuff, or taking a fish oil or a krill oil supplement, that's where you're going to be.
See, my wife eats salmon like it's her job, so I'm assuming if she were to take that test, she'd be in the nines at least.
That's
pretty
exactly.
Yeah.
Well, and
right.
Dr. Harris, I was telling you it was interesting because our producer Julie actually scored the highest, and she does eat a lot of fish because she's a pescatarian.
Okay.
I think, you know, we can't go on either without talking about why it's so important that you have healthy levels of omega-3s.
Right.
What are the benefits?
Right. The benefits range, as you mentioned at the beginning, from heart health, which makes your heart, actually the things we think about are our heart rhythms being keeping a good rhythm.
Firing the engine.
Firing right. And I like to think about having the right omega-3 level, kind of like your allusion to a car.
Mm-hmm.
It's sort of, if your cells are well-oiled, they move smoothly, there's less inflammation.
Yeah.
Okay.
And less heat generated, and you just live better and live longer.
You've said that this test is actually essentially like the new cholesterol test. Why is that?
A new cholesterol test, because people are very familiar with cholesterol.
Sure.
It's a risk factor for heart disease. You can't feel it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The only way you can know what your level is by measuring it. And, but it's usually at your doctor's office, and it usually requires a drug to fix it.
Mm-hmm.
The omega-3 index is like that in a way, except you want to have a high level instead of a low.
Of course.
Yeah.
But it's something that's a nutritional marker. It's a health marker, not a sickness marker.
Yes.
And it's something you can do at home. You can address it very easily by taking, again, supplements, or you can eat more fish. So it's a marker that's just as much a risk factor for heart disease as cholesterol is.
I love that you're saying it's actually an easy fix. You can go ahead and you can start doing something about it right away.
Right.
Speaking of being an easy thing to do, I'm holding a omega-3 blood test in my hand. Is this available to folks?
Yeah, right. They can go to, there's a website called One Heart, One Life that they can go to where they can get this test ordered.
And this is the test we took.
That's the test you took.
It's
very
easy.
It's pretty simple.
It wasn't here's a little note, bring this to your nearest blood place, wait for 47 minutes, get pricked and prodded 14 times. This is a real simple thing. Did it right at my desk.
Well, we did it at our desk. And you know, we were all a little intimidated because we had to prick our finger, but gosh, if they don't make it just super simple.
Oh my goodness.
And painless, I might add.
Absolutely.
Whoa, well
that
done.
Counts.
Well done.
I whined a little, but it was new.
Well, you always do.
I'm a whiner.
You know.
It's what I do best.
Yeah.
Raising the omega-3 index then. You say you can take the supplements. You can have the salmon. Is one way better than another?
Again, my background is nutrition, so I would first of all advocate eating fish.
Of course.
Yeah.
Partly because when you start eating fish, you stop eating something else.
Yeah. That's true.
Right? No, replace it with something
healthy. Replace it with something healthy.
You can't stop your fish with hamburgers.
That's right.
That's true.
So that's number one. But there's too many Americans that just won't eat fish. They just never develop a taste for it.
Okay.
Which is where the supplements, I think, come in. And then you've got fish oils, krill oils. There's some algal oils people can take who are vegans, vegetarians.
Yeah.
So there's a variety of ways to do it, but it's very easily addressed.
And doctor, have you taken the test lately, and where does your level
I take the test quite a yeah. I'm around 10%.
Wow.
Whoa!
Man, oh man.
My goodness, are you oiled up, buddy?
I'm glad you're sitting down. We're gonna have to throw you in the ocean. That's the way that works. Doctor, it was great having you.
Great to have you.
Honest to God, I knew about the importance of it, but I don't think there's really been an easy way to test until now.
I'm very motivated. This is excellent. And thanks for coming all the way from Sioux Falls to give us this great information.
Absolutely.
Yes. My pleasure. Thanks very much.
Give your body and mind and soul the nutrients it needs. Head over to oneheartonelife.com for more info on creating good nutritional habits. The Omega-3 Index Project is a proud sponsor of The Morning Blend.